You are such a hard worker. Or are you? You may think you work pretty hard, but the truth is, you're not working hard enough. But why? Well, let's talk about time for a second. If you're watching this video, you're probably wasting time. Time that should be going to your homework, your business, or your family. And how much screen time do you have on your phone? It's probably really high, isn't it? Look, you're probably not the best at managing your time, but it's not your fault. Time management is a skill that you were never taught in school, and a skill your parents were probably too busy to teach you either. And all around you are just distractions that are designed to take advantage of this every single day. But what if there was a way we could change that? What if there was a way to optimize your entire day to make sure that not a single second is going to waste? Well, when I said you weren't taught time management in school, I kinda lied. Let's turn back the clock. Remember back when you were in grade school? Every day your teacher had a schedule for you and your classmates. Every day you had a nice little timetable, telling you exactly what you'd be learning and at what time. Your entire school day was planned out for you, from the minute you walked in to the moment you left. These timetables gave our day structure, and us kids never had to wonder what activity would be coming next. But as we got older and were forced to manage our own time, we seem to have forgotten this important lesson our teachers taught us. So now, it's time for you to feel like a kid again. It's time to make your own timetable. But how do you make one? Well, it's really simple. First of all, think about all the things you want to accomplish in your day. Write down all the things you want to get done. This includes your habits and all of your normal responsibilities. Just write everything down. Got it? After that, all you need is a table. It's better if you draw one out, but you can always go into your notes app on your phone and make one with just a simple click. Make sure you have two columns. This is very important. Now, this final step is all about you. Start writing the activity you want to do in the right-hand column, and then the time you want to complete it in the left-hand column. Everything should be in chronological order, starting from the time you wake up, from the moment you go to bed. It doesn't have to be perfect, but just a general time you want to do an activity. You can see my timetable here as an example. Feel free to take inspiration and change it up for the way you see fit. And when you're finished, take a screenshot, set it as your wallpaper, and you're done. Just like that, your productivity is about to explode. Because now, you don't need to waste time thinking about what's next. You now have a regimen in front of you to follow. So great, you have a timetable now. But it doesn't matter how much you plan for your day if you don't take action on it. Sometimes though, taking action can feel like the hardest part, but you've already built your system. So now comes the most important step. It's time to level up your discipline. See, everybody knows what discipline is, but not a lot of people know how to actually increase it. Well, let's think about the gym for a second. If your goal is to get stronger in the gym, you can't just stay at the same weight forever. Every time you start a new workout, you always want to try and hit more than what you did last time, whether it's more weight, more sets, or more reps. This is called progressive overload, and it's probably one of the most important terms you'll ever hear in your life. But what does this have to do with discipline? Well, just like how we use progressive overload to increase our strength in the gym, we can also use progressive overload in order to increase our discipline. You see, think of discipline like a muscle, and just like any other muscle, the only way it can grow is if you break it down first. But how do we work out this discipline muscle? Well, I'll leave that one for Hamza, because I couldn't have said it better myself.
Get used to doing the hard work, even when you don't feel like it. I don't need motivation to do hard work anymore. I rely on my core values to lead me the way.
Look, so many people wait until they feel motivated to do something, but that's actually the opposite of what you should do. Because discipline, at its core, means to do something regardless of your feelings. So every time that you don't feel like doing something, it's actually the best time to do it. Because every time you push yourself and force yourself to do tasks you didn't want to do, you gained a little bit more discipline. And the more you level up your discipline, the easier all the challenges in your life will become. Every time we seek discomfort, we progressively overload our discipline, which will then make achieving our goals so much easier. But truly, the art of discipline is probably one of the most rewarding skills to master. Because with a high enough level discipline, no one can stop you. When you really think about it, the only thing that's ever stopped you in this world from achieving your dreams is you. The truth is, you've always been your worst enemy, haven't you? Look, if there's one thing you should take away, it's this. The only way to conquer the world is if you conquer yourself first. So now, the choice is yours. You now have your timetable, and now you have your mindset. So now, it's time to get to work. It's time to become a hard worker.